And what he found was that by studying the people who were right most of the time, in other words, the big professional trading firms, the big speculative traders, the smart money, as we call it today, he found that the smart money will act in the marketplace around what I now call logical points. And logical points are really a self-fulfilling prophecy. In fact, I was on the phone with one of the members today, and he even asked me. He said, "Hey, Mac, you know, is this stuff just a self-fulfilling prophecy or what? You know, or is there really something to this? You know, is there?" What he was asking me really was, "Is there really a way to reliably forecast the market?" And first of all, there's some caveats. The answer is yes, but you've got to have a free market. Okay, it can't be a fixed price market. And fortunately for us, even though we are trading directly against our broker, we don't have a fixed price. In other words, they don't have full control on price because there is the rest of the Forex market to contend with. And quite frankly, if the market got too far away from them, they would get basically crushed. So we do have a free market. We can use some of these techniques that were developed back in the 20s and 30s and quite frankly are lost for the most part today. Most traders, even most courses that you can buy, don't really talk about how the market is actually conducted. How do we conduct business as market participants? So what I'm going to do in this session is talk about two kinds of reversal patterns. Both of these are in the course. Later on, I will deal with a couple of patterns that I just couldn't fit into the course. I mean, believe me, if I tried to put every single last thing in that main course, it would be probably 50 different discs. What you have in the course is the core functionality. What I'm going to put up onto the member site as this thing starts to develop are different things that will help you refine and enhance what you're doing. But believe me, what's in the core of that course is more than enough to trade with. So I'm going to talk about two of the patterns in the main course, the Little Dipper and the Sneak Attack. Okay, so first of all, the Little Dipper is really great for confirming an entry, but it's not for pre-entry, really. You can use it as a pre-entry, but the ideal is to use the Little Dipper after you've already gotten in, and it's a way to confirm that the smart money is involved in a particular trade. And this really does apply for traders that want to or have to, due to work or business considerations, trade on a little bit of a longer time frame. So if you can't watch the market during the sweet spot and you're looking for something maybe to stretch out over a couple of days or a week or more, the Little Dipper is fantastic for deciding whether or not the market participants are likely to keep pushing the market in a single direction. It shows up on higher time frames and also lower time frames. But the higher time frames, of course, are a bit more significant, okay, because they represent a more information. Okay, what Wyckoff discovered is that the market really is about information flow. And when you look at, say, a five-minute chart, from one bar to the next, I mean, from 5 minutes to 5 minutes, unless there's a scheduled report, I mean, let's face it, there's not a whole lot that is going to happen in terms of major economic announcements. Every once in a while, you do get something that's called a tape bomb, where, you know, some unforeseen news hits the wire, like Bernanke gets on, who, if you don't know, Bernanke is the chairman of the Fed right now, and he's the United States, or Trichet from the EU, you know, one of these guys gets on there and he says, you know, contrary to public opinion, we are going to lower rates a full percentage point. I mean, the dollar would just go through the floor at that point. That would be a tape bomb. You know, an announcement of a huge multi-billion dollar corporate deal would be something along the lines of a tape bomb. Somebody getting assassinated or...